Shut up. Am I off the side?
Your shoulder.
Am I
on?
Is the music starting yet? Welcome to Chick Chat. Here we are. We're here live at the Rec Room, Adam's Rec Room. We're here with the fabulous Carrie Caravis, and we have looking fabulous today in her. Can we say where you got your shirt?
My shirt is a Kohl's shirt. Should we introduce? I'll tell you all about Kohl's in a minute, but
it's okay. Not an Ivanka
let's introduce my lovely Matt Burke.
Yes.
The handsome.
Very handsome.
Very handsome. And Jim Gallagher, also.
Also handsome. Also
handsome Matt, and then the other
handsome
guy.
Handsome in a rugged.
More rugged Marlboro man kind
man.
Of a way.
Sort of a bad boy.
With
manly
a scruffy, nerd kind of sexy.
Rode his bike in.
Okay,
yeah.
I'm hearing a delay, so we're going to have to turn the sound on.
Oh, then why did you have the sound on?
I don't know why it's a delay.
Okay, there you go. It's no button.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, so yes, my shirt is a Kohl's shirt. Now I shop at Kohl's a lot because, I don't know.
It's cheap.
It's cheap. You wear it once and you never wear it again, but I buy my kids' clothes from Kohl's, right? So my daughter needed bras.
Oh, wow. Already?
No, she doesn't need them, but she wanted them. I mean, she really doesn't need them.
That's how I was, too. When I was 10, I wanted them.
She wants to wear them, so we went and bought her. So I got some Kohl's cash, and then I bought a coffee machine. I got some Kohl's cash. So I went there today to get a shirt because I'm sick of Anna Drack telling me I have the homeless collection because I buy my clothes at Walmart, which there's nothing wrong with Target and Walmart clothes.
I don't go to Walmart because politically I'm against them. I will not shop there.
You don't want to get raped?
No, because I don't like, you know.
They get their workers?
They don't pay their workers, you know, the whole thing. So I won't go to Walmart. But I do love TJ Maxx and Marshall's. Those are my go-to places. And secondhand stores. I know that sounds gross, but.
It is.
Listen, I sell.
It's better than third hand.
No, listen, I sell vintage clothing, so I'm always looking for vintage clothing. Then I will be somewhere and see a fabulous something at a very cheap amount of money, and then I will buy, for instance, my black Italian leather boots.
You can ride with those.
$40
secondhand.
They're
horseback riding boots.
They're very Italian, and they fit my feet. So.
Well, the good part about the Kohl's is you get all this, you accumulate all this Kohl's cash, and you try not to. You have to pay attention because if it expires, they won't fucking give it to you.
Okay.
They give you a week after the expiration date. But anyway, I ended up buying five shirts today.
How much?
I paid $24 because I had all this Kohl's cash.
For five shirts, you paid $24. You paid $5 a shirt.
So this cost me $5.
Well, that's you're a very pulled together look today, I have to say.
I am. And my shoes, though.
Those are cute.
Can you see them?
Very cute.
Matt, can you see them?
They're adorable.
These are Michael Kors. He's got the, right? I never spend any money on shoes, but I had to have these. They were $160. Don't tell my husband.
Wow.
You got that with Kohl's?
Not even on sale. Not even on sale?
No, I just, sometimes I buy stuff not on sale.
Wow.
But he doesn't know that.
They're very cute.
But he bought these for me for Valentine's Day.
Oh, okay.
But he doesn't
know.
In
his sleep.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Were we supposed to have clothing shopping stories ready?
Yeah, we're bringing you in a minute.
Because Matt and I, we would have went shopping.
Usually we talk about
Marshall's down the block.
Something Carrie did the week, and then we move on.
Yeah.
So I waxed, do you have no clothing stories? You don't buy?
You see us.
Where do you? Well, you look like you might be shopping at Kohl's.
Target.
Yeah.
Well, Eddie Bauer.
Okay.
Close out.
What's this on the front? Maybe you could have washed your shirt before you came in.
Yeah, I'm not picking that up. Oh, Pat.
And I have 10 of these.
And where do you, all you do is wear black. Where do you shop? You're a big boy, so you have to go to the big boy shop?
No, I'll go to Macy's.
You do?
When I'm feeling extravagant.
He's always dressed to the nines. Every comedy show, he's got like a hot leather jacket on. A perfect
black suit. He'll wear a black suit with a black shirt.
Yeah, he always looks great.
Yeah,
looks
that's hot. True. He has a look. He has a definite look.
Thanks, guys.
He's got that Johnny Cash in a younger version way, right?
He is kind
of
Johnny.
What about my mind?
Yes, please tell us about your mind. Please tell us about the mind.
As dark
of
as your shirt.
Sexy man.
Yeah.
We were actually going to talk about drugs. Can we talk about drugs? Are you a drug taker? Or were you a drug taker?
You see the wardrobe.
Yeah, there was. I remember that history.
Wait. Were you?
Outside of Jimmy's Comedy Alley.
Bayside days?
Nothing severe, just innocent.
Weed?
Beautiful. Yeah.
What kind of weed?
Anything else? He's not very forthcoming.
Oh, there was worse stuff as time went by.
You look like somebody would have done LSD and stuff.
I never wanted to take pills or anything.
Really?
They scare anything you put in your body, and then whatever's going to happen is going to happen. I don't like that.
But what about pot you put in your body?
But it's slow. You're in charge.
If you pop a pill. We weren't in charge.
Yeah, we have not in charge stories.
We have different
stories.
In charge stories about weed. What's yours, Jim?
Well, my most, I had stopped for decades, and then I went.
Stopped what?
Everything.
Oh, like
and then I went to
drinking.
Amsterdam.
Uh-oh.
And
the mega capital.
So you go to a coffee shop.
Right. Like, you get know, a hooker.
It was funny. Well, that happened previous to that.
Did you get a hooker in
at LaGuardia.
Amsterdam?
Well, who does? I mean, I got one, and I'm not even gay.
Listen, no, I just like to window shop, because you can go past, and you go, okay, you know.
I have to tell you a great story about
that. And it's really good for your self-esteem, because if you're not going to do anything, the girl's like, come on, baby, come on. I'm like, really, I'm not interested tonight.
You weren't interested for real? Were you
I just wanted to boost my self-esteem.
So you go to Amsterdam.
Yeah, and he walks down, okay. What's that road?
They all wanted me. It's called the Red Light District.
The Red Light District, yeah. Right.
So
but I went to the coffee shop first, and yes. I felt like I couldn't just get a pot, so I got like a Diet Coke, and I'm like, yeah, that, the Diet Coke, and the joint there.
The weed.
And the menu.
It does feel weird. Yeah. It still feels like weird. You're breaking the law.
Like I'm buying my first condom. You know, I can't just buy the condoms. But they had a menu, and I said, look, I want something a little mild, and he was, you know, pick one
a
out
menu.
For me. And then he told me how to, like, he goes, just take like three tokes, and then, you know, then relax. So I took three tokes.
Oh, there's different grades, like stronger, and then go fucking kill yourself?
Yeah. So I took the middle, and then I took three tokes, and I'm like, I'm not going to smoke this later. Smoked the whole thing.
Oh, my God.
As you walk
that's a good idea.
To the red light district, it's like cobblestones, and I had like these Nikes on. I could feel every rock as I walked over. Like, so I got just to the edge of it, and I went, taxi, take me back to the hotel. That was it.
That was it? Well, what about your other one where you were with the cool kids?
Oh, I was in high school I smoked a lot. I'm like, I hang out with the cool, you know,
crowd,
pot kids, you know, with jean jackets and work boots.
Kind of this outfit.
Kind of the outfit I'm wearing now. Thank
this
you.
Is cool.
Thank you, Miss Coles Cash. I didn't have any Coles Cash, so or Caldor Cash, and then
Caldor.
I remember Caldor.
So I got in the circle. They're smoking this pot, and like I'd smoked pot before, and then you know, there's PCP in here. I'm like.
That's after you smoked it, they tell you.
After I smoked
Yeah, that's
it.
Nice.
So we're in this circle in the woods, and then I'm like, they're having a great time, and I'm not. And I'm noticing, you know, their arms moving around and the leaves, and they're like looking at me because I'm not saying anything. And I'm like,
you were flipping out.
I'm getting paranoid, and then I'm like, oh, I got to leave. So I get up and I walk through the, it wasn't even like a great path, and I'm falling on the trees, and I could hear them laughing so hard.
But did you feel violent or anything? Or you
felt like I was embarrassed. I'm not hanging out with the cool kids
they
anymore.
They gave him the PCP joint, and they smoked the regular one, and they're like, let's see this nerd.
Jerk. Let's kill him. Okay, my
PCP. Like, here's your math book, too, nerd.
My PCP story was, I don't know for sure it was PCP, but I think it was PCP. I had this boyfriend.
We remember.
Anyway, he was, you know him, he will remain nameless. But anyway, he had given me pot because I had really bad periods, you know. And I said, oh, I can take these periods. That's why they gave you yours. So I had this, he goes, take that. He left me a joint and he said, smoke this, it's really good. He said, and when you're done with it, eat the rest of it because that'll really make it stronger. So I go, I smoke it and then I eat it, you know, because I didn't really know how
Honey,
to do it.
Are you serious?
I've seen
You're not. You were that dumb.
So he leaves. He goes away.
I was going to say, I didn't know she was like that.
He goes home, and I'm laying in bed. I'm having the worst cramps. So I smoke this thing by myself. He's long gone. Smoke. I don't feel anything. I'm like, oh, shit, this isn't
working. Let me eat it.
I'm going to eat it. So I eat the rest of it, and all of a sudden I lay there, and I start like, I don't know, it's tripping or... All of a sudden, I'm laying in bed. I pull the covers up over me. I see myself
in a pool of blood.
As a bloody skeleton. And as I pull the blanket over me, it is my coffin cover that I'm pulling up over my head.
Watching yourself from the outside?
I'm seeing myself out of
body,
looking down.
Out of body experience.
And then I have this feeling like if I don't jump out the window, this feeling isn't going to go away. Like this feeling of extreme anxiety. And I'm like, I'm going to have to kill myself now. But it made sense at the moment that killing myself was a good idea. So
it's
then I think maybe I shouldn't kill myself. And then I'm like, all right, I'm going to call
Scott, the boyfriend, and I call him up, and I'm like, this is before cell phones. Like, he's at somebody's house. I go, listen, I smoked and ate your weed, and now I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to jump out the window. And he goes, don't get off the phone. I'm going to talk you down. I go, you're not going to talk me down. Either get over here in 5 minutes, or I'm jumping out the fucking window. And I, like, meant it. Like, it made sense.
He's like, I'll be there in six. So,
yeah. It's probably true. He hated me. So he get, but he,
thank God you weren't married to him, because he would have been like, never would've showed I'll be right there.
He did show up, and then I felt like, okay, I can relax now. And he waited until, I guess, the next morning, where my feeling of wanting to kill him. But then I had anxiety for, like, literally, like, 2 years I used to have anxiety attacks. I couldn't leave my house. I thought, why did I want to kill myself? It's the worst. So that was smoking weed for me. That is why I do not do drugs.
Look, that was the last time?
I was. Yes. I'll tell you the one and only time I smoked pot.
Okay.
I was at the church, Goya. It was the Greek Youth of America, whatever it's called. Goya. So I was like 13.
Sounds Spanish.
Goya church.
I'm 13. The guy I like is there.
Oh.
This girl and my 33. Cousin. So they light a joint during the break. We're outside. I took literally. Father Papa Janopoulos.
You were only 13.
I was 13.
I have some spina carpata.
So they all hand me the joint. I don't want to look like an
right.
You know, I was cool. I was the cool kid. So I'm not going to back down. I smoke cigarettes. So I took.
You smoked cigarettes?
Yes.
Oh my God.
So I hope my kids are not watching this shit. So I took two puffs, literally just to go hold it in. And I held two puffs, and within 5 minutes, I had a strobe light happening. And I'm like, holy shit. I thought the priest was trying to rape me. I thought they were trying to kill me. And from that moment on, I never touched it again.
Yes.
Or any drugs. That saved my life, because I was like, there's no way. Because everybody was dropping acid in school.
Smoking crack, the whole thing.
Oh, the whole thing. So that saved my life, actually. So I became a raging alcoholic instead.
This is the squarest drug conversation I've ever had.
Okay, what are your drug stories?
First drug stories.
Any bad? Yeah, what's your first time you smoked pot? You were probably really young or something.
Yeah, I was freshman in high school.
You were? How old is that? 15,
13, 14?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, 13.
And what'd you do?
Eighth grade.
Smoked pot?
Eighth grade. I got drunk first time in sixth grade, I think, or seventh grade. We
well,
went on a Washington
family
trip.
Members get you drunk.
No, we brought
not.
Booze. My friend's mother was a stewardess, so we stole a bunch of little bottles. And we drank. We
did you mix them all together?
Yeah. Put four together with some soda.
We called it the zombie.
Ugh.
And
you know what we used to do? We used to take our lip glosses, pop the little ball out, stick whiskey in it, and then drink it all. And it was disgusting. It tasted disgusting, but we all did
it. Tastes like
it.
Bubble gum and
I
whiskey?
Have yeah, never
bubble
gum.
But your lips look fantastic.
Strawberry and whiskey.
I was always afraid to drink because my father drank, and I was like, I do not want to be like him, because I saw Days of Wine and Roses as a little kid. And it's like, I am not going to end up like Lee Remick, who leaves her baby and her husband because she's an alcoholic. And I remember thinking, I'm watching that show, and I'm like, I am not going to be an alcoholic. I am not going to drink like my father drinks.
And your father looks like Jack Lemmon.
And then I never drank till I was 26 was my first drink. And then after that, I didn't drink. And then I got drunk once and I did pee on someone's front lawn. And then after that, I didn't drink again till like I met Kevin when I was 45.
I always peed on everybody's lawn.
When was your drinking period?
I drank from the time I was 13 till the time I was 27. Then I quit. But I did pee one time. I remember. I don't know if you guys remember Long Island Buttles. There was a next to Zachary's Buttles, and there was a line out the round to get in. So I run up to the bouncer. I go, "Can I just run in, please?" I was already plastered. I go, "Can I just please go in there and just pee?" And he goes, "Nah, you gotta wait online." I go, "No. I just want to." And I would get violent if you said no to me. No, I just want to. Like, I was just there. I want to go back in. You gotta wait online. So I stood. Got in front of him, in front of the whole line, turned my ass around, pulled my pants down, took a piss, pulled my pants up, and the entire line was like.
Did you go live that day?
I had a cute ass back then. I didn't care.
That is so weird because it was probably hot for guys.
Yes, but my friends were like, get away from us. Like, we couldn't even, no matter where we walked in the club, they were like, get away from us. And I remember one guy goes, are you the girl that peed? I'm like, that was me.
I was with the girls from, what's that show we did? Women Tell the Dirtiest Jokes with Carol Montgomery. And, oh, well, I should tell it the day Carol Montgomery. But anyway, that was the day we were driving back, and I peed. I couldn't hold it, but I was drunk, and I hadn't been used to drinking. So I'm like, just pull over here.
But you pee every 5 minutes
I
now.
Pee every 5 minutes.
So you need a diaper. Just wear a diaper and just save everybody a lot of that
relax.
Pulling the fucking car over. Driving to a gig with her, it's like, pull over. Gotta go to the when's the next rest stop? She, wear the fucking diaper, and then let's just get to the where we
go.
Gotta
with
go.
Rich Walker. He doesn't stop. He's like, I'm not stopping.
No. No, he doesn't stop.
That was my first husband.
He gave me a Snapple bottle. He's like, I can't stop. Like,
did you ever go in a Snapple
bottle? I would have pissed all over his car.
It was crazy.
I went in a thing once. Oh, one of those plastic Tupperware.
I did. I peed all over my
hands. And I went all over the seat.
All over the seat, on my hands. It was disgusting.
You got to do a Snapple bottle.
And then in the summer, when it was hot, the seat would smell like urine. I would use that shampoo. I had that shampoo, and I think it's perfect. And then it'd be a hot day, and the windows are shut, and you get in the car, and you're like, oh,
where's the homeless
like
guy? Where's the homeless guy?
And somebody's like,
am I on the E-train? So tell us,
so
Matt.
What about your drug stories? We want to know your drug stories.
I don't have anything fantastical.
Well, did you ever do...
He just got very mellow, I guess, right?
Yeah.
Did you ever snort coke off a hooker's ass? A
fat guy.
That's every guy's dream.
It is?
Yeah. Snorting
have
coke
you guys been
over.
With hookers, by the way? Have you been with a hooker?
Have you been with a hooker?
That I've never done.
Okay, bullshit.
Neither of you?
Really? It's a multi-billion dollar business, and neither of them have
I'm
been
Irish.
With a
we don't pay for that stuff.
So you just don't get it then, right?
That's right. I told you, I like to go up to the hookers, you know, interact with them, and they go, I'm really not interested. But it's a fantastic boost for your self-esteem.
I went to Amsterdam.
Yes.
Like, I've been there like 10 times. So one time I was with Debbie Perlman, and I don't remember who else. So we're walking, and we turn the corner, and we're in the red light district. I don't realize we're in the red light district, and I'm filming, and all of a sudden I hear Debbie go, run! And I'm like,
why?
What? Because you cannot film them, their windows, and they're in their underwear. I didn't realize that. So she came running at us with a bottle of water, and she was throwing it at us. And Debbie got wet. She's like, she's spraying AIDS on me. and all you saw was my feet running with the camera facing down. And I'm laughing so hard because... I didn't mean to film them, but I apparently did. And the guys in front of us were American, and they were obviously shopping around, right. And they were, like, running with us because they all thought we were all together. They're like, why? We're not even a part of this. But they will kill you.
What do you mean they'll kill you?
If you film them, they have, like mafia guys that are bouncers. They're bouncers, whatever. They will kill you. They will beat you up. They will
They're pimps. Are they pimps?
Yeah, they're pimps. They will... hurt you bad, they told me.
If you take a picture.
If you take a picture or film them. I didn't know.
But wouldn't you think that
she
would
ran
be...
after me. She had her garters on. And I'm like running.
Debbie Perlman?
Wouldn't that be good, though, to just post their pictures? Because then people would see them and then go, I want to go to her.
That's
you want
their
the point
day
of
job.
Sale, I think.
That's their day job. They don't want to be known at, you know, famous.
Oh,
like that.
I see.
But so when I went back, because I was, they had a lot of comics go there from America and do their comedy shows and their TV shows and their comedy things. I went back with my husband. But he was my boyfriend at the time. So I said to him, let's go to the red light district. And he's like,
Did you want him to get a hooker? Okay.
I said, I will get you a hooker.
You did not.
Oh, I did.
Why are you so much like a man?
And he's like,
now, damn. You
know, that's when he's like, will you marry me?
And he proposed. Right there by the water.
Right by the Anne Frank house.
The smelly canal.
Your choice or his choice?
My choice.
All right.
See, you're thinking of mine.
So, what's the difference?
Look at Matt.
I don't get the
I wanted to see if he was going to take me up on the offer. So he's looking at me and he's going, really? I go, yeah, I'm going to get you a hooker. We're in Amsterdam. It's legal. And he's like, you're going to let me get a hooker. I go, yes, I am. I'm going to pick her out right now. So now I've been there like 5 times, so I knew where the good ones were and where the nasty ones were.
Really?
So I come around the turn, and there's this 600-pound...
Stop.
I'm not making it up. You could call him. She's this big in a chair. I go, her! And he goes, her? Now, he's stupid. He should have said, okay, let's go. Let's go. I'm not hurt. And I would have been like, no, I'm kidding. I don't want you to do it. So he's like, no, thanks, no. Like, my husband's very shy. So I go to him, let's go to a sex show. Because it's like a movie theater. You go, you sit down, and you watch a sex show, right? Yeah, yeah. I mean, I was there. I might as well go and see it.
Yeah.
So we get there and we're watching.
Not the Anne Frank house or the Van Gogh Museum.
That's Van Gogh.
I'm in Amsterdam.
Come on.
She wants the real culture.
I did go to the Anne Frank house myself.
Matt, that's the Van Gogh.
How many times can you go to that house? So.
Same story. Story never changes.
It's still a house. It's a different kind of house.
She dies at the end.
Right.
Stop.
So we go into this movie theater, and you're sitting down, and you're scared to touch anything because it's like you're scared that you're going to be sitting on sperm.
It's gross. It's gross. Right?
Watching the action, and it's weird because you're watching two people screw in front of you. And the whole time he's like, can we go? Can we go? Can we go? Can we go?
He's not into it.
How much? Shut up. He goes, you're the only girl here. You're the only girl here. I'm like, there's one other girl. She's on stage. I'm not the only girl here.
She's busy.
And that was it. We left. He made me leave. We were there maybe, I'd say, 10 minutes, and then we were out.
Were they attractive at all? I saw
they were gorgeous.
Two lesbians at Times Square at the sex show. And one was
Patty. What happened right before that?
Well, that was my...
Was that right after the PCP?
She was alone. She wandered off.
Gay guy that I met in my acting class, his name was like Simone.
Gee, what a surprise.
Something. Anyway, he was a hairdresser, and he was like 70. So he was very old, but he spoke like this. And he goes, we must go to Times Square. Like, I ran into him somewhere. He dragged me in there, and I watched these two lesbian girls. And I think I said this. Did I say this at the last one or whatever? But at the last one,
she stuck her
mop in the floors and everything else. Ugh. But
wait. Then when the thing opened,
the big black girl,
she had pressed her
vagina against the glass with her foot on either side like a barnacle. And she made it go open, closed, open, closed, open, closed.
Must have looked like those vats of squid they have in Chinatown. Yeah.
That is what it looked like.
That's what it looked
like. But aside from her, because I already told that story, but the other girl. Girls were like lesbians, and they're like doing all this stuff to each other, but they were so like unattractive.
When you
it's
say
like
all this stuff, example?
Things girls do to each other.
I'm a visual person.
You know, they were doing each other's hair and makeup.
But I remember them having these weird feathers clipped to their hair. I don't know. So they came out with these feather things. It was just the most bizarre. I just can't believe guys. What guys will fucking
you know
don't
what
watch
I realized,
anything.
I know they will, but I realize you can be talked into anything.
Anything.
Eat the joint. Swallow. I mean, there's so
lesbian
many
suction
things.
Cups.
I mean, Patty.
I was very naive. I guess I still am, but I would always go, "Oh, okay." I didn't want to hurt people's feelings. Like I would never say no. Like he's going, "No, you got to go." And I really did turn this guy down like four times. Like I really don't want to go. He goes, no, we're going to go. We're going to go, darling. He had this like fake English accent. And I was like, I really don't want to go. And he drags me in. And it was like, it's traumatic.
Yes.
You just see these disgusting people. And the guys who go in there are just the lowest.
The sit-ums. They're the squirrely things.
Right. Horrible. But anyway.
So
we were like 16 or 17.
You went with your friends?
Yeah.
And how was it?
We didn't stay long. We were like, no.
You got scared?
Not really scared. Just like, this isn't for us.
Were they attractive, the girls?
No. No one was attractive.
Huh? No one?
No one.
That's
the thing.
I went to a strip show also with a guy when I was in high school or college. A friend, I think he was an ex-boyfriend of my sister. I don't know who he was. But anyway, he takes me to a strip club for some reason down in Utica, New York. You have to know how ugly the strippers are in Utica, New York.
Nothing in that town.
She comes out. I thought like a stripper is going to like go, let me entertain you and swing her glove around.
The minute you walk in the joint.
And she'll have things on and wiggle. No, these bitches come out buck naked, and she's holding a nasty, ratty towel. Not even like a sexy boa.
If
she's holding a towel.
What an IV needle hanging off of her.
She puts the towel in between her legs and rocks back and forth on this nasty towel, and that was her dance. There was no finesse. It's like, if you take me to strip show, I want to see some finesse. I want to see
dancing.
A girl. Some
you
want to
see burlesque.
I
want to see burlesque.
Yes.
Right. You could see that at La Cage Full.
Yes. I didn't understand what I was getting myself in for.
It wasn't Swan Lake.
It was not. It was very uncomfortable.
Now, you've never been, Jim?
He's been to strip clubs.
Strip clubs.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, the last time I was...
Yes, when?
the last time my dad had just died in Ronkonkoma, and I was talking to, you know, Sal.
Governor what a Allen. Way to mourn.
Sal,
huh?
Governor Allen. Well, listen, Sal goes...
I'm so upset. I need a tit.
No, I didn't say that, but I am...
Sal Gavinelli?
He's like, stop by my house in Hicksville.
Who's Sal Gavinelli?
That's,
Sal,
come
the
on.
Stockbroker.
Stop from the Stern Show. Sal.
Oh, Sal. Okay. Mm.
So after the funeral, I stop by his house. He goes, oh, we'll go out. So I'm like, all right, him and Billy Meier and me, and then they take me to a strip club. I'm like, what am I doing here?
Yeah, right, what are you doing
were
here?
Were you crying while the girls were dancing?
My mood picked up a little bit.
Your father was
my
there.
Dad,
in
my dad would have been proud.
He was in spirit. Yes. He was there.
Lap dances.
But they come up right away. Like, all right, let's get a drink. And right away, she's like, "You want a private dance?" Yes, that's exactly what I want after my dad's funeral.
And
so,
did
no,
you?
No.
No, you did not.
No, I'm like, what are we doing here? So
Sal is and, such a prick.
But they come up to you all the time. Maybe I shouldn't have used real names here.
These girls are trying to make money. That's how they make their money. That's what's so sad.
Yeah.
We went right after high school. We found a place that would let us in. So we went every night almost for that whole summer. And that was it for the rest of my life. I'm kind of done.
But wait a minute.
Strip
shows. But would you? How much money would you have? How did you have money if you're in high school?
We had enough.
Would you tip the girls or anything?
Yeah. That's because they're all in love with you.
Right.
When you're 19.
They must have loved when you young boys came in, right?
I guess.
Yeah, because you don't want an old, fat, smelly weirdo. See a bunch of hot little boys.
Yeah, I know.
Like,
that,
right.
I can imagine they'd be like, oh, this is easy.
Yeah.
This will be easy to get some money out of them.
But it was easier back in the day because you could hang out. They wouldn't bother you. Like, as soon as you got in, they're like,
yeah, this
private
was kind
dance,
of a low
private
tech.
Dance.
This is
you
a
could
low
hang
tech
out
place.
If you just wanted to drink and then... throw a couple bucks in there and you can hang out for a while. But now you can't.
What do you mean you can't? They don't
can't
let you hang out
anymore.
As soon as you walk
now
in the door,
that,
private,
give me
dance,
money.
Private dance?
Yeah, there was
no
private dancing
show,
at this
you
place.
You just have to do...
Well, how am I supposed to make any money, Patty?
That's not right. Adam, I have a quick question for Adam. Never a prostitute either?
Okay, that takes too long when you go...
I'd like to speak with counsel,
please. Do you have a
please.
Microphone? Can we hear you?
No.
Does your cousin count?
You mean you were going to go with a prostitute, but you didn't have the money?
But there's always a bachelor party that the girl is willing not only to shoot a basketball out of her crotch, but she's also willing to do a couple of favors for the groomsman and the groom.
I've never done that at a bachelor's party.
That's his story, and he's sticking to it. You do.
Now, I guess they don't consider that a hooker, right?
No, that doesn't count. Right about
that doesn't.
Body?
That is a hooker.
That doesn't count.
Well, it depends on what the legal definition of prostitution is.
Okay.
How about the comedians who go, if they're 50 miles away from the house, it doesn't count?
Like that's a whole different area.
If
you screw your landlord for the rent, is that prostitution?
Yes.
That's necessary, actually.
But it doesn't make you a hooker.
It doesn't make
does.
You a... Well, no, well,
yeah, you're hooked for
hooked?
Your rent.
Right.
So that would make you a hooker.
But you have to
well,
file
then
that
I'm
in your
a
taxes?
Prostitute because I'm waiting for that pension. I'm hooking
you're hooking
him,
your husband.
My husband for the pension. So I guess, yes, it does.
Wait a minute. Before we move on.
Well, I want to know.
I want to know what was the prostitute that you were with.
Oh, no, I wasn't. I'm just saying I have no moral problem with it.
Oh, you have no moral problem to be with a prostitute.
Oh, yeah, he's
useless.
But you have a girlfriend, so
doesn't
I'm talking.
Doesn't matter,
yeah.
But
so,
not when
yeah,
he's
that
got
was
a...
the that was the right answer. You should have said, "I can't. I have a girlfriend."
I'd say, like, when I was single.
Oh, when you were single. Okay, that's what
so. Wait, bachelor party? Never.
I went to one of those with the girls,
and
it was just ridiculous.
What does that mean?
It wasn't sexual.
Yeah, no.
It wasn't sexual. No, it was just ridiculous.
And then you're there
watching
with, like,
some of the guys. Actually, some of the drunker guys maybe thought it was sexual, and that was funny for everybody else.
Oh, it wasn't? I always think those things
are
sexual.
No, there are. It depends on what kind of girl you
but
get.
That's why. Oh, sorry. When I get married, I don't want my fiancé having a bachelor party because you know what happens.
You're not
at those.
Getting married.
I'm going to get married. I'm going to get married. When I get married.
Someday.
I don't think. Now, if you'll get the dances you're going to get by that point are going to have walkers, They might break a hip. But here's what,
guys always go, no, no, that's never going to happen. We're just going to a restaurant. And then after the restaurant's over, then they go and they get the rest.
But you know, I'll tell you why you can't. Because, like, your brother's there, your
family.
Yeah,
but they send the brother home. They send the father-in-law home. I know what you guys do because I've heard. I know. I fucking hang out with comics.
Oh, no. They send the brother-in-law home. They send the brother-in-law home. Obviously.
And then they go bang somebody. That's what you guys do.
Well, we just make jokes about the dancers.
No, you know when it's a bad bachelor party? When they go... We're going to go for 2 days
to Vegas. Those are the bad ones. You know it's hookers at
they're
Vegas.
At the Bunny Ranch or whatever it's
called.
Yeah,
that's when it's bad.
That's bad.
I don't trust him. Mm-hmm. Did your husband have a bachelor party, Karen?
We're getting a lot of O's.
What does that mean?
That means really? Ooh.
Too much?
Did my husband have a bachelor party?
Yeah.
No.
Did he want one?
I don't, you know.
Would you have let him have one?
He has no friends.
Harry.
No, I'm serious. I'm not making it up. The guy has no friends. I wish he did. He'd get out of the house a little.
What'd you mean?
And he's got like an ass indent in the couch where he sits.
Wait, I have to talk about something.
I broke
your
phone.
My phone.
I know I broke your phone.
Oh, my God.
It's fine, Patty.
I'm just going to break my phone. You waxed your husband's back on Facebook.
I waxed his back because...
That's the new book?
What's the new book?
I waxed on my husband's back on Facebook.
Oh, that's a new book.
Oh, no.
You did
She's
it live?
She's self-publishing.
I did it live.
It was amazing.
My favorite part of you waxing the back is, I don't know who, it's like you have 12 people living in your house. She's chasing
yeah,
down,
always...
and these people are like, ay, ay, yo, boto, what the, I don't even know what language they're speaking. It's like, hey, beep, 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 beep. It's like, you're housing immigrants. I don't know who these people are. They're like, and they're coming out screaming with their arms up in the air. I'm like, who are these people in Carrie Kravitz's house?
So he's eating. Now, so it's a three-part live. It's first me at the beauty supply store picking out the right wax. The second part of the live is me breaking it to him while he's eating his dinner salad out of a tin. Because I didn't have time to make dinner.
Okay.
So I go, listen, I bought some wax. I want to wax your back. And he's like, you see his expression. He's like, no, not going to happen. I go, I bought the stuff. You have to get it done. I'm sorry. Because, you know, when you sleep next to someone that hairy, sometimes I wake up and I think there's a bear next to me. I'm like, oh, my God. Like, I get scared thinking I'm going to get attacked from an animal. So I got the wax. So whatever. So then I had to turn the cameras off and beg him. And then I promised him, like, you know, a little action. And he agreed.
He went for that, too.
He went for the action part, but...
Okay, hold on to that phone. You're scaring me. Put that lower on your thumb.
So, we're good. We're good.
She's going to drop my phone again.
So I get this stuff ready, and that shit is hot. It dripped It dripped on my hand, and I burned my hand.
So as
I'm getting this ready, my friend is in her room, and she's watching it live. As I'm wiping his back down, she's hysterical laughing.
That was your friend just in another room?
Yeah, in her room. Okay. She is staying
she
with me.
She does stay with you. And she doesn't speak English, right?
No. I have everybody staying with me. It's like the revolving door for immigrants.
Okay. Trump's on his way.
She's laughing so hard and I can't stop. I'm gonna pee my pants because she's laughing so hard. She's like, I can't. You know, she's screaming. And I do the first strip, and I know how much it hurts to just do a little bikini wax.
Yeah, yeah.
It really does hurt. His hands are this long.
When you showed the white thing after, it was just long, black so hairs. Gross.
And he ran. Oh, my God. It was so funny. And then I did, I did a patch about this big, and then he goes, I'm done. But I didn't do
that.
Did
he let you finish?
No, I just did two strips on Facebook Live, and then I stopped it. And I was like, let me just do it. I'm not going to do every strip on Facebook. And then I stopped it, and he wouldn't let me. So then I buzzed his back 2 days later. I buzzed the rest of it off. And then he broke out. He broke out in, hives, the whole back.
Your husband
he
lets
sounds
you do
so
it.
Hot.
Do you guys have hair? Are you hairy men?
Of course.
Are you hairy backed
of course
men?
He is.
You look like you're hairy.
Look at my arm.
Oh, my God. You
He's
are hairy.
Disgusting.
What about the back?
I don't
what
have
about
hairy
the
back?
Back,
though.
Are you sure?
You want to check?
Yeah.
Carrie will look. Because, Carrie, I'll be honest. I thought your
it's
husband was going to be super hairy.
Yeah. Is he crazy? So
you can Let count them. I'm not like your husband, though.
No, he doesn't have that bad.
Thank you, Pat.
Oh, he's got hair all over his
back. He's got hair all over his back. His
wait,
crazy?
I just put this on for the show. This is not real.
He's got more hair than your husband, but let me say
this.
No,
I don't.
Yes, you do.
Her husband is not that hairy. Her husband, when you said he's a big hairy bear, I'm expecting, oh, my God,
no,
when
Patty,
he pulls up the shirt.
No.
It did.
You couldn't see it because he's got gray back hair. So it looked like
it's
he
blending.
Really
was
didn't
Was that
have
the
it
last
in.
Straw? Does that make it worse when it starts turning gray?
Did you want to make a little design in there? Like make a face?
I wanted to just carve my initials in there.
Matt, do you have hair? You look like you don't have any because you don't have no chest hair.
No, he's perfect.
I have chest hair.
Is it lower?
Three strands.
You shave the top or what do you do?
I wouldn't admit to it, but on stage sometimes you don't want to look like an old man.
Yeah, sprouting out of your shirt.
Yeah.
You don't have any on your back.
No. You know Carrie's going to
well,
test.
Well, aren't you going to check? You got to check. They check me.
I have like randoms.
Let me see.
Carrie's looking. He doesn't look like he's that hairy.
Completely hairless, smoother than I am.
Have you done the electrolysis and all that? I've had that done.
No, but I do have one long hair that just keeps growing out of the side of my face.
You never had to get electrolysis when you were young?
No, I'm hairless.
I had a mustache in my 20s. Okay, here's the worst part. And I was afraid, I didn't, you know, it didn't occur to me that I should, you know, if people don't go, what's up with your mustache? For some reason, I didn't notice it.
It was fine.
So it was like a Fu Manchu down the two sides, right? Just these little long, thin black hairs. And I thought, that's not that noticeable. I used to put the Nivea, you know, and it bleaches them blonde, and you think that's going to help. So I was dating this boy. It was horrible, horrible, horrible boyfriend. Who
has
like,
anyone ever been good?
No, he used to eat soup in front of me. And I go, this is after we had sex. And I go, can I have some soup too? And he goes, I don't have two. And I would still sleep with him. Okay. But anyway, I was such a loser.
Did he take you to a strip show?
No. He was horrible.
I was such a loser.
He never took me anywhere. He was. And so anyway, we're in bed and he's.
Is he having the soup at the same time?
No, this was right before. He goes, I have this little game that I play. I go, really? What's that? He goes, well, I knew this girl that whenever she had something really important to say to me, she would say it in a British accent. And I'd go, okay. He goes, do you care if I do that with you? This is the weirdest thing I've just remembered. So I go,
you did date a bunch of fucking losers.
Okay, go ahead. So he goes, all right. And he does this British accent. He goes, have you ever thought about doing electrolysis? And I was so humiliating. And then I answer back in a British accent. I go, no, I haven't. Is it that bad? I'm not even making this up. And he goes, I think you could use some. And I had a couple of hairs down here in my chest. And I was like, I went home and I cried. And I thought, oh, my God, I'm this hairy
I hope
beast.
You punched him in his face.
I didn't because I was guy a wimp. Said a wimp, that a wimp.
If a guy said that to me, I'd be like, have you ever, ever thought of sucking your own dick?
Well, fuck
he
you.
Also,
fuck you.
Had the smallest penis.
Ever.
I have ever seen.
Well, why didn't you address that?
Why didn't I address that?
In the British accent.
Yeah. It was
What's
the elephant.
What's with your little crumpet?
The elephant in the room.
Elephant
your
in
crumpet.
The room.
It was the elephant in the room. I never said, but he felt the need to talk about
okay,
it.
Okay, but his
adventure.
Little dick, you couldn't say, have you ever thought of maybe possibly getting a pump implant?
It's awfully small.
Fucking horrible.
I should have.
Your life is a history of psychotic relationships.
It is.
Psychotic.
Everyone she tells.
Every one of them.
Everyone is mad. But yeah,
and she married a gay guy.
There were like two nice guys, but then I didn't go say going out with
them. You settled down with the gay guy.
I know. Now I got a good guy, but it took me.
I don't know about that. He's not married.
Kevin's a good guy, though. Kevin's
he's not married. She's been up 12 years. Marry the fucking girl. My God.
My laughter is so... Carrie can't. I sound like a crazy person.
Why don't you ask Kevin in the British accent? Would you like to get married?
Kevin,
dear?
Would you like to get married?
What's the?
It's been 15 years.
Kevin,
15 years.
That's the security.
Can you not afford the jewels?
No, he's good. He'll marry me. I have complete faith in him.
He'll marry you soon.
Maybe he's writing to us now.
He's not even watching.
No, he watches. So maybe
now
he's
Matt's married.
Matt, how do you like the married life?
Wait, I want to ask Matt one thing.
I want to ask.
Did you were you into your wife? Did you want to marry her? Were you romantic or did you have like a gun to your head like my husband to marry?
Well, like, it had been like 4.5 years.
So you felt pressured to do it or you wanted to be with her?
I did want it. I didn't want to be with anybody else.
But okay. No guy ever really wants to be married, though, correct?
No guy has ever sees like, himself yay! Jumping yeah. through the field. That's a woman's thing.
Right.
I have. I've been
doing
a
guy
once.
Says, I'm not going to do better than this. This will be a great mother for my kids.
I'm not going to do better than this.
That's fucking...
That's very romantic.
You know, wait a minute. What you just said, my husband said that to me once.
What did he say?
I swear to God, he goes say? To me, well, I had... We were talking about marriage and how getting married and whatever, and he goes, well, I had my share of really beautiful women, and...
And now
me, right? So now this is after I just had my kid and I got really fat, whatever. And I go, whoa, 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 whoa. I go, whoa, whoa, whoa. Did you just say you had? Are you fucking kidding me? We had the biggest fight. I go, well, let me see some of your fucking loser girlfriends that you had that were so hot, hotter than me. I remember your ex had that long, Mr. Ed head. She had that horse face. We had the biggest fight. I go, you are telling me like that you settled for me? You settled for me? Uh-uh. Let's get this straight. I was 40 and desperate. And you were the only one I could convince to giving me the sperm.
That's right. He doesn't know who he's
doing. Did you hear
with.
What he just said?
But he doesn't see anything wrong with what he just said. He's like, why? What did I just say?
I met somebody who would tolerate my
shit.
No,
that's not what you said. You said, I'm not going to do better than this.
Yeah, I'm not going to find somebody to put up with me better than she does.
Okay. He's translation.
He just changed it a little and made it better.
Changed it a little, made it better.
He changed it a little. So now, okay, here's what I'm going to ask you. So you have how many kids do you have?
Two.
You have two kids. Okay. So I was watching the Grammys. Anybody see the Grammys?
And this I don't is coming watch back that to garbage.
Okay. So let me just say, Adele goes up there. It was actually Lady Gaga and Metallica, and she jumped off like the mosh pit. But anyway, all right. But it, as what's her name? Adele says when she gets her award, she goes, "Oh, you know," she goes, "I was feeling like I wasn't myself."
Did you ever think about electrolysis?
Once my baby was born, I lost myself, and I think women do lose
we
themselves
do.
When they have their babies. So my question to you. As a man, because as she was saying that, I'm thinking, you know what? Women lose themselves. I lost myself so bad those first few years. I just looked at myself. I just, like, where did I go?
Well, I lost my crutch, that's for sure.
That happens. But men, I feel like you don't lose yourself. You have a kid. Did you lose yourself or not?
Yeah, I was pretty
lost. Oh, you did lose yourself?
First couple of years.
Oh, that's my phone. Here, give that to me.
Patty Bailey?
Who was? Didn't you have a swagger?
You were hot. You
had a swagger when you walked in a room.
No, I always hated myself.
Really?
That's why he's
most
a comic.
Comedians, yeah,
a comic.
Most comedians, yeah, we do. We
too.
Hate ourselves.
You actually gave me the advice when I right before my daughter was born that the first 3 months are so awful, then all of a sudden it stops, and you're like,
yeah, oh, yeah, that's true, it. Kind
I'll
of.
I never
right?
forget that you told me that.
Yeah, because you know what?
Patty's always a full of like encouragement and like good news.
No, but you know, I
tell me the worst 3 months of your fucking life.
But
you're
you
gonna want to kill yourself.
It's good to hear that because I remember I went to work and my daughter was a baby. This is at Comedy Central. I don't want to brag. I was with Jon Stewart. Okay, that was my career. It was fucking over after that. But anyway, and then I got fired. Okay. But when I went in, and I remember my kid was up all night. She had colic. I hadn't slept in like 2 days. I'm trying to do this show. I'm like, I remember thinking, I'm going to take my baby, and we're going to jump out the window. And the director comes in. He also had gotten fired after. And he goes, and I liked him, of course. So he goes to me, how are things going? I go, I just want to kill myself. I want to jump out the window and take
again
my kid with,
the
with
window?
Me. Again with the window. I wasn't even
PCP
high.
PCP again?
And he goes to me, he goes,
you're
that's
fired.
Smoke this.
goes,
smoke this and eat
he
the rest.
Goes, that's normal. He goes, don't you know that when your kid's screaming the head off, you're going to hate your baby? I go, oh, don't say that. I'm never going to hate my baby. He goes, everybody hates their baby for a minute or two. You're going to hate your baby. And I go, I will not ever hate my baby. He goes, you're going to hate your baby. He kept saying it. But what you do is, I was like, get that thought out of my head. But you do think like, this kid is fucking annoying. And you want to love your baby so much. But then this kid won't go to sleep. And
shut the fuck
and
up.
And has colic and is in pain.
I had a friend.
For 8 hours.
I had a friend that had a colic baby. And she couldn't take it anymore. She just put the whole crib in the closet and shut the door.
She was going to say in the
she couldn't do it. I was like, you didn't just put the baby in the closet, did you? She goes, yes. I can't take it. I fucking can't. I can't. She was like, she couldn't sleep. She's like, I'm tired. I can't take
it. The doctor does tell you if you're going crazy, because they don't ever want you like losing it, is to walk away. Put the kid in a safe place.
The
walk
closet.
Into
yeah,
the room.
The closet.
Shut the
door. She shut the kid out
and
of the
then
closet.
You just
and
have
it's
to
so
get,
weird because,
get a hold of yourself.
Because her kid's gay now. So I guess he came out of the closet.
Oh, Harry Caravis.
That's a long way to go for that one.
No, but it was a true story.
You don't want kids? Oh, you have kind of a kid, then.
I have kind of a kid. I have an ex-stepkid, I guess.
So you help raise that kid? How old is that kid?
21.
Do you want us to not talk about this?
No, you can talk about it.
Okay. So you help her, you move in her furniture, you tell me you move in her
take
furniture.
Take her back and forth to college. We go visit her.
Wait,
now,
so
where's the real father?
Her ex.
Where's the real father?
I don't know.
Oh, so you're the real father. So when she gets married, you're going to walk her down the aisle.
No, her uncle will. But I'll be there.
So what the fuck are you paying for?
Pay for nothing. It's easy.
I ain't moving anybody college if I'm not going to walk them down the aisle.
I give her driving lessons.
So she's like your kid.
Yeah.
Is she like your kid? Like your stepkid?
Eh. No, she's not.
Well, I mean, her,
I mean,
her mother and I broke up, so it's not quite the same. I hope.
Right.
I hope.
I hope what?
Oh, we're alive. I hope the best for everybody.
You want to go back to talking about hookers?
You hope the best for everybody.
Well, that's how we met, actually.
Have you been?
She was working. What's up?
What'd you say?
He goes, let's go back to hookers.
Yeah, he's very uncomfortable. We're going to move on from this conversation.
Yeah, that was so comfortable, talking about the hookers. It's a business deal, you know.
But now that you're... Okay, we're moving away from that.
Yeah, that was
that's
quick.
Very uncomfortable.
That's like enough, Jim.
Okay, so with your kids...
All righty, Jim.
You love the whole dad thing, or how is it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, now
as long as
cool.
I can go out at night. I'm glad I have the job I have.
Yeah, yeah. So are you the dad for the day? Like, are you... Does
Mom.
Your wife have
Mr.
a
Mom.
Job?
Mr.
Yeah.
Mom.
And you're
Mr. Mom. It's a little bit.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
But they're in school, so...
So when they were babies, you were with them full time?
Certain days, yeah.
Oh, my God.
I remember.
We had mother-in-law to help out, though.
Oh.
So.
I remember when they
I don't
were...
know how people do it without help.
I did. Yeah,
well,
it was hard.
Yeah, I had them back-to-back. About 40 and 41, so I had two babies back-to-back, and I remember when he used to get home from work, I'd be like, I gotta go to Pathmark! And I would leave the house.
You couldn't wait to get
yeah,
away.
To
would,
go into the grocery store
the
and be like,
supermarket.
I love this! Like,
I know.
I love it.
I know. I lived in Brooklyn, and I had my two kids, and of course, my ex-husband, we weren't even getting along, so he wouldn't help me with that. He'd go on the road. I'd have this baby. My parents, my sisters live far away, so, like, no one could help me. We didn't have money to get a babysitter. So every time I left the house, the babies were with me. And I remember the woman downstairs goes, she's Italian, and she would wear these halter tops, and she was crazy. And she goes, so, how do you like having kids? I go, good, good. She goes, it's like jail, isn't it? She goes, it's like being in fucking jail. She had two kids and they were kind of semi-grown. She goes, look at you dragging them every place you go. And I'm like holding them. I'm like, yeah. And sort of me was like, it is. Because you like,
fucking,
you can't like
it's
get
like
away.
Thing, what they put on you at jail?
Yes,
what
like a lock, the ball and chain.
No, not the ball and chain.
Oh.
They put that thing like
the
a
radio.
Wristband.
Oh,
well,
you
can't go far.
Yeah, yeah.
In-house prison.
House arrest.
It was hard. That was a hard time. Mm. But then once they can kind of like watch themselves and you can run to the grocery store, then that's...
Oh, you know what I did?
What?
First I bought a playpen, the little square thing, and I put my son in there to play. And then slowly but surely, as the kids both started becoming like one, you know, one and two, I would buy those connected... get fences.
Oh,
you know,
yeah, yeah,
the
yeah,
playpen
yeah.
ones?
Yeah.
The plastic ones.
Yeah.
Like you put chickens in?
Yeah.
That is kind of what it looks like.
Yeah.
Then.
So I slowly did, you know, seven of them or eight of them, and I made a box. And then they would get more toys. And then at one point, I had no living room furniture, and I had a really big living room. It was a living room, dining room connected with a cathedral ceiling. The whole thing was a playpen. Because I did not want to. I wanted them to be entertained the entire time they were fucking in there. Because I couldn't handle it.
It's just so much work. I remember I used to carry my kids around because my kid would cry all the time. If I didn't hold her, she would cry. So when I did the dishes, I'd put her in that thing on the shoulders.
Yes,
you know that thing? And I would do the dishes. I'd cook. She'd be up there. You put her down. She's like, I'd be like, I have to kill myself. I'd pick her back. I'd put her in that thing. I'd keep making the eggs. You put her down. You know, but anyway, it was so horrible.
Did you breastfeed?
I did.
I did too. Please.
Did your boobs look like after?
Well, you know what? I'll show everybody. Hold on.
Yeah, we had to show our backs.
no one sees my tits.
Nobody really wants to anymore.
Even the kid's like, okay, that's enough.
Yeah, so basically...
I ate when I was out.
Yeah,
my son wouldn't latch.
Wouldn't. You got to get a lactation consultant.
I was
consultant.
Pumping. I was shoving him on. I was making him starve to death. I wasn't producing enough milk. So finally, he
what
got
is
like
the Himmler, the Himmler
childbearing school. It's tough love at a young age.
So he finally, after a month, I still dried out. My daughter, the minute she came out of me, I shoved her right on my...
That's what you have to do.
That's what I did. She sucked right away. Right. I got 4 months out of her.
This is Chick Chat.
Yes, it really is.
I'm sorry, we're getting back to you in a minute.
So I got 4 months out of that, but it hurts like a mother. Your nipples are rip, roaring, raw,
cracked,
bleeding.
Cracked and
bleeding.
Cracked
but and the best part of that is once you get past the 2 weeks of the pain,
big boobs,
then you're fine. And then the baby cries, you just stick it on your boob.
I have always been a 32 less than an A, just like teeny. I can't even fill out an A cup. I'm so small. I was a 36D. Woo-hoo. I was gigantic, and I loved it. Like, when I would walk around, I was like, this is what these bitches feel like.
Walking like a girl. You feel like a
girl. You are so confident. You walk in a room, and it's like, that's right. Here they are. Like, I'm in the fucking running now,
that's
you know?
That's right.
Where's the dude with the English accent then, huh?
Exactly.
Who cares about a little mustache?
Fuck that guy.
Nobody would have noticed the mustache if you had the girls out.
They don't notice. That was like, and then after I stopped breastfeeding, it within 3 days, they just went down to just, and I go to my friend, I go, I don't know what I'm going to do, because I was single then. I go, how can I ever have sex again? These breasts, they look like skin hanging off. And she goes, they're not that bad. She goes, they're not that bad.
Let me see.
Let me see. I go, okay. I go like this. She goes, oh, God. She goes, those look like two pop balloons. Oh. She goes, what are you going to do? But the good news is if you're breastfeeding, that it does plump back up after.
Yeah.
You get some.
All right, let's see.
Anyway.
Now, my husband, I actually breastfed my husband once.
Yeah, they want to know what it tastes like.
He's like, what does that taste like? What does that taste like? I'm like, come here. And all of a sudden, I'm like, all right, get off.
They like
tastes it. Like sweet.
Did you breastfeed?
Milk.
Sweet. It is sweet.
Like,
did you
sugar.
Suck your wife's breast milk?
No.
Come,
I didn't.
Don't fucking lie.
Liar.
No, I didn't.
You really? Weren't curious at all?
No.
You never tasted just
did
off
she
your
breastfeed?
Finger?
She did, yeah.
Oh, good.
For how long?
For, I don't know. The boy was a long time.
Like 2 years?
Yeah, almost.
That's what I... See,
well,
I did
that's
it...
That's a lot. I wish I could
I did toddlerdom, and like people were like... My mother was like, what is wrong? That's disgusting. Because, you know, I did the little H.A. League. You know, you do it till they say no more. But then kids will never say no more. So at some point, you go... I bought her a Pocahontas doll. I said, you want the Pocahontas doll? No more tit. So she gets upon it. She's playing for like 6 hours. And then she looks at me. She goes, Bubby. I go, no, Bubby. You got the Pocahontas doll. She's like, Bubby. Mommy. It was so sad. But you got to break up
well,
with them.
My the Greek women would breastfeed like the whole neighborhood. I know one woman.
Oh, yeah. They're wet nurses or whatever, right?
They would lactate. And then they would just their kids.
Half
and then
the
everybody's
story.
Kids. But one kid was like, he was like 6 years old. And he was still on his mother's tit. So. Get off.
That is what I know. That is sort
kids
of
got a paper route already. He's like, yeah, I gotta go home and get my mom's boob for a little while.
So, okay, let's talk about something the boys can talk about. Matt, why are you in comedy? Here's my theory. Here's my theory. I feel
I'll give you my class ranking.
People are comics because they have kind of crazy childhoods or bad childhoods, which I have to rethink because my daughter's a comic, so maybe she had a bad childhood. But and I'm the mother, so I had to rethink that. But that is sort of a theory I have, that there's something, you know, people have crazy or weird childhoods, and that makes them a comic. Is that true or no?
Well, you know, in line with what you're saying, so my parents had 6 kids. So now, like, after listening to you guys, man, that must have been crazy. And it's Irish kids. So, like, every year and a half, there's another kid.
Oh, yeah, they pump them out.
So I'm in the middle.
You got breastfed?
Probably
not. No recollection. You know, the Irish, so they don't.
They don't
apparently
love their
children. They had 6 kids, so they had sex 6 times. It was not enjoyable. They never had it again, according to them. There was no...
Are they still together, your parents?
They,
or your father
they
died?
Were.
Or your father
they,
died.
Well, they both passed away, but they were together until the bitter end because they're Catholic.
Okay.
But I was telling about my mother and my father. Two, you know, it's opposites attract. So my mother's family's outgoing, very...
was she Irish too, though?
Irish,
black.
Irish,
black.
Black Irish.
Black Irish.
And then my father was very rigid, non-emotional.
Yeah,
very,
that fits together good, though.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't.
That makes a comic.
No, it does. It does for 5 minutes. And then you're like, this is a boring motherfucker. And I really can't. I got to find somebody like me and enjoy the things I enjoy.
That's what my mother was like. But she's Catholic. So she's like, I got to stay here. You know, I remember my mother hurt her back in the backyard once. I don't know, I was about 18, and she
shoveling snow.
She was working, and she
did she shovel?
And then she looked. She was like, "Hurt my back." I'm like, "Oh, mom, you're right." And my father walks over, and he looks up. He looks at her. He goes, "Don't lean on that table too long." And then he walks away.
Wow.
And my mother's like, "Oh my God."
Well, your father, he had a lot of his father in his act. He would talk about his father. And you used to do a bit about how your father, when he was done with the conversation on the phone,
That was it.
He'd be like, "All righty, Jim." Click.
That's the funniest.
Well, I call
him. All righty, Jim.
I call him in Florida on Father's Day, like, happy Father's Day, Dad. Well, your mother's not here. Like, Father's Day. Oh, okay.
You can't say I love you to your
mother.
No, I love you. It was like, go wash your car.
Did he ever say I love you
never.
To you? Never. The Irish fathers, they never say I love you.
No, a lot of people can't.
My father didn't make eye contact with me. And then now it's a therapy set. This was so funny. It was my brother and my father. We had three jobs, and I was the youngest, so I wasn't allowed to touch his precious machines, you know. And he was the trimmer machine, and my brother was the lawnmower. He's like, "You weed all the gardens." I'm like, "I'm the littlest kid here. I have asthma. I'm in the house filled with smoke." And he drags me out there. I'm like, and he goes, weed the garden, get the roots, get all the roots. So I have to stick my little fingers out like this and go. And there are weeds like as far as the eye can see.
Child abuse.
So at least if you're mowing the lawn, you go, "Whoosh, oh, I got a little bit done." But with the weeding, it's like, you know. So I was just like, and he's
horrible.
Like, "This kid is lazy." And I'm like, "Why don't you let me touch the machines? Let me just touch a machine." You know?
I can't.
So then my brother, when I grew up, I was not allowed to mow the front lawn because apparently I was just not as good as my brother.
It's terrible.
He
and then
in a shape.
But one day, I was like 13 or 14. All my friends are mowing their lawns, and my dad goes, look at that. What is that?" And I go, "I don't know. What is it?" He goes, "You on the edge. You nicked a little." I go, "I can't even see it." "That's it. Your brother does the outline for the lawn, and you mow the middle." In the back.
Yeah.
So this was until my brother left the house.
So you were completely a fuck up. In your father's eyes.
Yes.
You
yes.
never could.
Yes.
There's always that one kid you're like, "This fucking idiot."
But see, this
and then the first time I did stand up at Eastside, I came home, I told my parents, I'm like, "Yeah, I did stand up." My father goes, "You didn't get paid for that, did you?"
That's my
thank you, Dad.
Now go out and mow the back lawn, but just the middle.
Just do it. Do it how we used to say thank you. Goodbye.
Well, he would just go, when he's done, he's got to go. He just goes, "All right, Jimmy, click."
Click.
And
not
I wouldn't really know if he was gone. Like, I could hear him taking the breaths when he's getting ready to, you know, okay.
Oh, he's trying to get off the phone.
Click. He's gone. And that's it.
That was so funny. I was in a, speaking of that, when you say that about your father, I was in a play called Gay Dracula, and I was naked in the play. So anyway,
Was this before or after the kids? Yeah.
This is Patty.
Before the kids.
Patty.
Were you lactating?
How did they talk you into that? You went naked?
What? Because I took a stupid class. Do you know Fisher Stevens, the actor?
Yeah.
His mother is Sally Fisher, her name is, because he took Fisher. Anyway, she ran this thing that was like an est camp for actors. And it was like, if you're late, you got to wash the bathroom floor. It was like all stupid bullshit. So anyway, I took it because I really wanted to be an actress. Yeah. So you take it, and then they do breakthroughs, and they break it down. They break you down. Oh, I see where you're blocked. It was all bullshit, but so they could get $600 out of you. So anyway, I took the stupid thing, and they said, what you have to do is you have to audition for a play this week. And I'm like, what am I going to audition for? There was an audition for Gay Dracula. I'm like, all right, I'll do it. I didn't know I had to be naked in it, so I auditioned.
Okay, you were the only one that didn't get that memo because you were the only one that went to that audition.
No, me and one other girl. So we both did
the
audition.
Why would there be a naked woman in Gay Dracula?
There's fat girl.
Two women and one of the and I have my little flat boobs and I'm, you know, 20, whatever, one or six or whatever I was. And the other girl has gigantic tits. Okay. So they go, okay, we've got two teams. You're going to have to be naked.
Wait a minute. You were naked?
And he goes to me, he goes, okay, for the audition, you know, you have to be naked in the show. I go, oh, I have to be naked? He goes, yeah, we need to see you naked right now and to make sure that you can do it. And I had never been, like, naked. And I'm like, okay. And I'm just like, because I wanted to say in my acting class that I had tried out for a role. So I open up my thing and I do the line with my little flat tits. And I was really skinny back then, so they were even smaller. I was like.
So you were completely bare?
No, my waist. And it was just, you have to open up to show your tits because Gay Dracula goes, ah. because instead of like
it makes perfect sense.
Instead of like garlic or the cross, you showed the breasts of a virgin. So I'm playing the virgin, supposedly. So I showed the tits of a virgin. They're like, ah, it miraculously goes like that. So anyway,
did Eugene O'Neill write that?
It was terrible. In the actual,
it was Arthur Miller.
The other girl, of course, gets the weekend spots because she's got the big tits, and I get the Wednesday, Thursday, Sunday.
You're the weekday tits.
I had the weekday tits. And and even at the very, I forget where the story was going in the beginning, but
your father.
My father. Oh, yeah. So my father called.
Your father was directing?
My father. But just to say, that fucking bitch, at the very end, weekdays, you get like 12 people in the audience. Weekends, it would be like 150. So at the last thing, I go, hey, can I do one of the weekend shows? Would you mind? She goes, no, you can't. That fucking big-titted bitch. Anyway, so my father calls me up. My father calls up and he goes, my mother calls him and she goes, your father wants to come see you in your play. I didn't tell my parents I'm naked in a play. I'm not going to tell them. She goes, and he's going to bring one of his friends from work. And I go, Mom, I go, I'm naked in the play. She goes, oh, dear. She goes, she goes, here, let me get your father. So she puts my dad on the phone and I go, Dad? And he goes, yeah. And I go, you can't come see my show with your friend. He goes, why not? Because they were going to come on Wednesday night. Like, they already, like, and I go, I'm
they already
naked.
Bought the ticket.
I'm naked in the play. And he goes, okay. He goes, oh, Patty. He goes, here's your mother. He just hands the phone back to my mother. And I go, what's he doing? She goes, he walked out of the
he
room.
Threw
and
up.
I'm like, I go, do you think he's mad? She goes, I don't know. But when I talked to him later, he goes, I am extremely disappointed in you. It was really sad. But anyway, that's what he just like handed the phone back to my mother. God. Like they can't have a conversation about it. It's just like
He's seen you naked and he didn't want to get embarrassed by his friends.
I know that would have been hard. Imagine if he just showed up without telling me.
Oh, that would have been hilarious.
Anyway. Horrible.
Any gay stories?
Any gay stories? Did you do theater?
No,
did you do theater?
In college, I did. I didn't do any plays. I just studied.
What do you mean you didn't do? How can you study theater and not do a play in college?
Because there were like the those people. Like,
and then there was the guy smoking.
And then
pot.
There was there was the pothead acting teacher.
You were
take his classes.
Oh, okay. So you were never in a theater. What was your job before comedy?
Student.
Wait a minute, you did comedy right out of the gate?
Yeah, I was still in college when I was doing it.
So how long have you been doing comedy? That's a long time.
I don't know. I was 19, I guess. When I started,
very young.
48.
You were very young.
She was, too. She was there, practically.
I was 25 when I went full force.
When did you start wearing the hat?
What hat?
Oh, I was younger than
her
that.
Her studded hat.
Yes, I had a hat.
Wait a minute, what's your hat?
I used to wear a hat on a little baseball hat.
Oh, no. I remember. Did you wear
something? Now my head grew. And I can't fit a baseball hat on.
Did you wear a little white hat, or is that your sister with a yachting hat? Did you wear a yachting hat?
I don't
on stage?
Remember, Patty. I wore a lot of stupid. I wore thigh high boots. With weird.
She had a lot of costume changes.
So yes, I was very young. Actually, 1987 is when I started taking Joan St. Ange's class at the East Side Comedy Club.
Okay,
and
so
Kevin
like
James was in that with
really?
Gary Valentine,
Rock Rubin,
and Adam Ferrara.
Get out.
Yeah.
Wow, a lot of famous people there.
And Joan St. Ange never put me on. Like, I took her class.
You wouldn't show your tits.
Me?
No, she always put the boys on to do the improv with her. And she never.
During the show, right?
During the show. Class. After the class, it was. After the class, the audience would come in. And she'd go, Rock! And Adam and Kevin and Gary in this scene, Mr. Know-It-All. And then I'd be like, the girls would be sitting there like,
really?
And Jim.
That's bad.
And she never picked me, ever.
Terrible.
And the one time she picked me, it was like, there was no audience. It was like four people. It was a snowstorm or something. Carrie! And, you know, whatever. She just never liked women.
Were you nervous when you did it? Improv is nerve-wracking.
I wasn't really nervous, really.
You don't get nervous.
I wasn't nervous. But so then I started, my stand-up. I was very young. I was young, and so were you. You were younger than me.
I was like 89, I guess, my first time.
I was
80. Then eventually I joined Rob Bartlett's improv and sketch.
Right, 89 is when I started around there.
I didn't even know Rob Bartlett had a class. So funny.
Rob Bartlett and the Bartletts.
I loved that show. I actually paid to go see that show when I was first starting. I thought it was hilarious. And they would; those girls would come out and be backup singers and dancers. It was hilarious. He is my one of my favorite. I liked his joke. He goes, "I like my women the way I like my coffee." Only now I can't remember the punchline.
With big tits.
With big tits. That's the punchline.
Oh, that's what he would say? Yeah. With big tits.
With big tits.
He likes his coffee with big tits. That's good.
That's good coffee.
I love that joke. He was hilarious. Loved him.
He started me. He's the reason.
He did?
He's the reason I'm in a basement in Queens.
Getting no money.
Talking to five greats who can't speak English.
Eating
on Facebook.
Eating Carrie Caravis's fantastic food
my hummus.
I love that hummus from Chirelicious.
Patty brings, every week I bring hummus and whatever, and Patty brings open bags of chips that are stale. She brings me with a clip on it, with her hair clip on it. She goes, oh, I brought some chips, and I brought some stuff for the...
No, here's
the thing. They've been opened.
I've never... No, now the popcorns, though, those were not open.
Those are individuals.
Those are individuals.
Okay, but...
There's only three.
You brought a bag of potato chips that were open, Patty.
Yes, but here's the thing. I never remember that I have to have food when I'm coming down here, and then as I'm leaving the house, I'm like, oh, my God, I got to bring some kind of a snack. And I didn't know that you were bringing all that. And I did bring the waters, but you didn't need the waters because you also brought the waters. But, yes, next time I'll bring snacks that haven't been opened with fingers in them.
Thank you.
We all don't have a restaurant.
Well, then you should get one.
Yes, sorry. All right, any other? Let's see. I have some questions for men.
Okay. We'll go
have you ever told a woman you love them to get into their pants?
What if you did love them?
that
and you
counts.
Wanted to get in their pants.
That counts.
Jackpot.
That's a yes.
That's a yes.
What about a woman you didn't love?
One girl that I went out with, it was right after a serious breakup, the first love, so I'm devastated. But this girl wanted to go out with me.
Wait, she was your first love?
Broke up. I went out with this other girl who liked me. Okay. And then she said, I remember we were in the backseat of the car making out. And she's like, can you give me the world? And I went, I don't know, maybe Cleveland?
She did not say can I you swear give me the world.
God, oh, Cleveland, I could give you
the world.
You did not say I can give you Cleveland.
I swear to God.
What an asshole.
I was working on my act.
Nobody wants Cleveland. Yeah. Even the people in Cleveland.
Yeah.
She didn't
want it either.
You did not say I love you.
No.
And that's what she was looking for.
Yeah. Now, let's talk about this whole month of, bullshit with the, Valentine's Day, which Patty... I bought you a Valentine's Day present. I bought you shimmer.
It's a sex toy.
EOS sheer pink chapstick. It's like a chapstick. It's a ball.
Oh, my goodness.
You rub the ball on your lip.
I'll chapstick
do that
balls.
Now. Thank you, Carrie. I didn't get you a present.
That's okay, Patty. I knew you weren't going to. But I feel that Valentine's Day is such a bullshit holiday. And what did you buy your wife?
Just the usual flowers and candy and a card.
That's good. That's good.
I just think it's like...
Just to knock it off.
But why? Why don't you just do it all year long?
Oh, who's saying I don't?
I'm going to have to call your wife.
But...
Do you ever go to your... Like, one day just go home...
It's not like a big thing with us, Valentine's Day.
I just think it's stupid. I just think you should, though, like in June, bring some flowers home. And a beautiful dress or a gift card to Bloomingdale's. Not when you fuck up, just for no reason. Just because she vaginally had two kids.
No, she didn't.
Oh, she C-sectioned?
I don't have to buy as many flowers. Oh, I can get
you
babies.
She C-sectioned her kids.
Yeah. So then that's great. Her vag is in check.
Wow. Did your husband buy you anything good?
No, he bought me so many things that he doesn't even know it.
Oh,
I had an hour and 20-minute massage, and I wrote his check.
Yes.
Signed his name.
Yes.
And he bought me these shoes.
Yes, nice.
And I charge them, but not on his charge, but he will pay that bill.
Yes.
So he's always buying me stuff all year round. I have the best husband in the world because he never checks the bank statements.
He doesn't?
No.
Oh, my God.
So dumb. Like, I could be having a big affair behind his back. He doesn't go through my phone.
Really? My fiancé knows everything because he always does my... computer and my this, he would know every single, like he'll go to me, hey, you got a message from so-and-so, you didn't answer back. I'm like, oh yeah, thanks. I'm like, so, it's, everything's transparent with that. Also, he gives me roses every week, once a week, boys. I'm just saying.
Oh, because you know what? Because he knows he's in the hot seat for not marrying
you. That's true, he hasn't married
Stoller,
me yet. Maybe
Stoller.
When he marries me, then it's Stoller.
Those flowers will stop.
This will hold it for another week.
Why do women accept the bullshit that are flowers?
What do you mean?
And look the other way.
What do
you
mean?
You know exactly what it is.
Wait, say that again.
Flowers for you. Oh, thank you so much. You know, in the back of your mind, he's groveling one way or another, right?
He did something wrong.
Yeah.
It works. I love flowers.
Or
that's
he's trying to keep things.
Love it.
No, I had a boyfriend once.
A boyfriend?
Yeah, and he used to always come home like every other week.
See how when she says, I had a boyfriend once, she doesn't follow with, I hated this fucking guy.
He was crazy.
No, because I'm friends with all my ex-boyfriends.
I know. See, she didn't date mental guys.
So I did, but I'm still friends with all my ex-boyfriends because I'm mental.
There's some nice ones.
So he would come home just randomly, and he would bring me I was walking by the store when I lived in Manhattan. He's like, I saw the shirt in there. He goes, I bought this for you because I thought it would look really good on you. Like, he did stuff like that all the time. He would bring flowers. Like, he's like, oh, I love sunflowers. Sunflowers are my favorite. So he's like, he would bring sunflowers home. I'd come home from wherever I was, and I'd see them on the table with big, you know, flowers. He was just that kind of guy. Turns out he was gay. No.
So, and not just the seeds? He brought the whole flower?
No, yeah.
Because
so
I brought my ex the seeds.
He was very thoughtful like that.
Was he cheating on you?
No. Maybe.
So he was just a good guy?
No,
he was
maybe.
A good guy.
Why'd you break up with him?
I mean,
him
do you know
so
if
good?
They're really cheating on you? I don't really care if they are. If you don't get caught, I don't give a shit.
Yeah, that's what I that's
but
the way I
feel. But
if
you get caught, pal.
I'm with you. It's like if you do it, but don't tell and don't fucking confess. You know these people who feel like they need to confess? You know, like, or you ever have like a girlfriend
on his dying bed? He's like, by the way,
I fucked
400 women.
Don't tell me.
300 were hookers.
Don't.
While you were sleeping upstairs.
Do not confess. I've had girlfriends, they go, do you think I should say that I did? No, you
no,
never tell
and
them.
Don't tell them your history.
They don't want to know your history.
No, don't tell them the history. Even if he asks you, like my husband goes to me, how many guys have you slept
never
with?
Never tell
I go,
them,
a thousand. Thousands. Thousands. How many of you? Three? I've had thousands. You want to conversate? You want to keep conversation going? Because you're going to lose. You're going to lose.
My ex-husband was talking to my daughters, and he goes, yeah, I don't think she's been with that many people, either two or three. And my daughter goes, do you think that's right, Mom? You've been with two or three? I go, that sounds good. That's about right.
Your dad was one in three.
Yeah. So, you know, but yeah, they don't want to know. Men don't want
to
know.
No, nobody wants to know.
Nobody wants to know. I don't want to know about him.
Look, when you tell someone your past, you're giving them ammo.
Yes.
Ammo to throw back. Well, you slept with her.
Yes.
Or you
that's
went
right.
With that hooker. And let me tell you
why
something.
Why can't I tie you up?
I know. You. Yeah.
Why can't
Why
you?
Can't we
it's
bring
true.
The sheep in?
It's true. But you know what? You can't tell people your past because they love
that's
they
male ego, know. Too. Men don't want to know that for just ego reasons.
Right.
But I feel like female ego is the same
they
because,
think
like.
The best one?
I don't want to think of my. I don't want to think of Kevin as being with other girls. I remember I said to him once,
that's all I think of right now.
This is very personal. He'll probably get mad at me for saying this, but I go, hey, I go, you know, I'm thinking, I go, what if I ever got breast implants? He goes, that's weird. They're just weird. They don't feel right. I go, you felt breast implants? And he's going, you know, like then he said too much too soon. And he's like, oh, I don't know. I go, what do you mean? You said they feel weird. He goes, oh, yeah, I guess I felt them. You know, I felt them. I go,
on a mannequin.
Subway.
I go, do you have your last girl, your wife didn't have breast implants. He was with her for like 20 years before
bitch.
Me. I go, what about the girl who was at the hospital? She had, he goes, no, because I could know all the girls. I go, what about that one? She had, he goes, no. And I go, who the hell had the breast implants? He goes, well, I guess it was a stripper. I go, you felt up a stripper's tits. I suddenly lost all respect for him. I'm like, now I have to picture that in my head. Like, I don't want to picture him with a stripper.
But yeah. Here's the weird part. You remembered everything about his past. If you asked me one thing about Sam's past, I could not tell you because I have no fucking clue. I don't even remember my own past.
But you really don't want to know?
What about Sam's ex-girlfriend?
I don't care.
You don't care?
I could give a shit less.
Why is that? Maybe
I don't know
because
I'm like
secure.
A guy.
You are
like a
guy.
I read the card and then it goes in the garbage. He's like, you're not going to put it up? I'm like, no. It's just more fucking garbage in this house.
You are like a guy.
I'm a guy. I don't care about cards. I don't give a shit.
I save all the cards in
I throw
big
them
box.
All in the garbage.
I save them. I even say the envelope because sometimes they do a little drawing on
it. See what I'm saying?
It's that's why my house is a mess.
I can't remember anything he's done in the past.
Really?
And you know, these guys do a lot of disgusting things, like with their friends. They'll get a girl. They'll talk a girl.
She's talking about you.
True. They'll have one best guy friend that they always go out with, and then they'll get one girl back to the room, and they'll both be doing her.
Yes.
So they don't mention all that.
I would have mentioned that first if it ever happened.
Yeah, we would have been bragging about that the whole time.
I don't know. I just can't believe we have two men here who haven't done some crazy shit, and they're comics. Because, you know, when you're comics and you're a guy and you're standing by the door after your show, what an easy way to pick up a girl.
They can pick
up. Oh, really?
No, they can
How
pick
many
up.
How many have you met after the show, really?
I've been married for 13 years.
Yeah.
But, okay, good answer.
Before that, it was all about getting
fucked up. No, now you're probably getting more action, not more action, but more women throwing themselves at you because they know you're married.
That's right. When you say you're married on stage,
you're more
then
secure
girls like
now because you don't need to.
He goes, oh, yeah.
I don't see that.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe I'm not looking in the right spot.
Guys just lie. Can I tell you this one thing that this guy said? This
guys
guy that
just
I know.
Lie.
He's talking about, he goes and got a massage with his wife. And she said to him after the massage, she goes, hey, you know, they do these other kind of massages for guys where they like do like with the special gel and, you know, they put
with
it
the happy
and
ending.
They rub them off and whatever. And he goes, like, and of course he's had them a million times. And he goes to his wife, are you kidding me? He goes, they do that? Like, with a straight face. And he's like telling me the story laughing. So, you know, I mean,
come on.
You guys lie, let's
You've
be honest.
You've got massages.
You've
with
got
happy
massages.
Ending.
You've done something. Come on. You had a massage.
I never got a massage.
Okay, you have to give me that phone back. You cannot drop my phone again. You're breaking my goddamn phone. Oh, my God.
I think I'm a lot better than any massage therapist is going to be anyway. I rub myself down. I'm like, do you want a happy ending, Jim? I'm like, yes, I do.
Oh, you mean on your own self?
Yes.
I thought you meant for a woman. Do you ever give a woman a massage?
Yeah, I'm good.
You are good?
Yeah, my husband sucks.
My husband, that was a mistake. My fiance. He gives me foot massages that are out of fucking
I know.
Out of this world.
Kevin's foot massages. When you were on stage last.
He, you know what he does after I get my foot massage? I just lay there. I'm like, it's like, and then all of a sudden, I fall right. It's the most, I don't know what it is. It's like giving me drugs. It's like me drinking again. It's so fantastic. It's like pressing a point and I go right out.
Then he heads out of the room, drinks up.
It gets rid of me. Is she not in the thing?
Oh, God.
What time is it, by the way? Just
by
so
the
now.
Way, my husband will not touch my feet. He'll go. And
why?
I don't have bad feet. Okay, my feet are not bad.
Okay.
But he'll say to me, I'll put my hoof in his face. He calls them my hooves. He goes, get your hoof out of my face. I go, no. Massage my foot. So I have to, like, really threaten him, and then he'll do it for, like, 2 minutes, and then his hands hurt. He sucks.
I hate when someone gives you a shitty massage, like, because you get all up for it, and then they do, like, when a guy gives you a girly massage, or when they do that chop-chop shit at the end, no chop-chop. Get fucking in there and get my muscles and push and work. Because when I give a massage, I mean, I don't last that long when I give them.
Well, but your neck hurts, right?
I go in.
You have to sit in a certain spot.
My neck and everything. Yeah, but I expect, you know, if you're going to give it to me good. That's really, you know.
That's the that's book.
Do not do this shit.
That's the book. If you're going to give it to me good.
By Patty Rossborough.
Don't be going little round circle skin
surface. Like, you know, I had a girl do that to me once. Every time I go away to do a show, I always scope out where the massage people are. And she's massages my back, and I was like, I wanted to turn around and go, hey, are you going to go down on me, too? Because this is the worst fucking massage I've ever gotten in my life.
You didn't say that.
No, I wanted to. It was like right here. It's here. Here.
It's horrible.
Seriously?
Now, can a female get a massage like that?
Yes, I actually talked to this one girl, an Asian girl, and she told me she went for a massage, and he was doing her whatever, and then he just sort of put his hand there next to her, and she didn't stop it, and then he gave her a
happy
ending.
I think he was just doing that on his own.
She's really pretty, really pretty
girl.
Hold
on a second. Would you stop it?
Yes. Are you kidding?
Look me in the eye. Come on, Patty.
Come on, Patty.
Kevin works his way up from the feet.
No, of course I wouldn't. I mean, I'm first of all, I'm very monogamous. I'm very monogamous.
Forget Kevin for a second.
If Kevin were dead.
Oh, my God.
Well, I don't
because
mean,
I can't I break
mean,
up with him.
I don't mean
he'd have
kill,
to be dead for me to...
I don't mean kill she, Kevin off. Let's just pretend it's before Kevin.
Okay, before Kevin.
You're in Vegas. You're doing a show for
Vegas.
A week.
Okay.
You order a massage. The guy comes up. He's drop dead gorgeous.
Yeah.
Now he's massaging your back. Next thing you know, he accidentally slips. And do you stop him?
You're asking the older woman now. So I just don't see me going, okay, let's go on with this. I just don't see it.
Who would say that in the first place?
Let's continue. Can we speak in British accents? I would yes, let's proceed with the operation.
Are you trying to finger me? Are you trying to...
Is that two fingers?
Well, no, I think I don't think... It would be weird. Like, I'd be like, what's this guy doing? Like,
what if you were drunk?
Well,
I never drank until
so
I
you wouldn't figure
until
it
I
out.
Met Kevin.
You wouldn't figure out what he was doing?
I would say no.
I've never had that happen to me.
Would you say yes?
I've gotten a lot of massage. Of course.
If you would
was,
say yes?
If he was good looking. And
for
I was
a happy ending?
Single, honey, and I was... No, I don't know. I probably would say yes, but...
You are like a guy.
I am a guy. I'd probably say yes, but forget that for a second.
Okay.
A friend of mine was in Thailand. They were doing some sort of a show or whatever, and she got a massage, and this little Asian guy was there. She goes, and the next thing I know, he's got his hands, and he's massaging my crotch. And I was like, excuse me, can you take your hands out of there? See, now that I'd probably say no to.
If he was
ugly and weird, no. But if he was a good-looking, hot, young guy, masseuse, with muscles.
See, if you were a guy, then it wouldn't matter if he was ugly. And
right.
See, for me, when I used to get massages, I got him a couple of times. I always wanted a girl, but one time I got a guy, but he was gay. So the thing is...
You never... Have you ever... Maybe Kevin's gay and we don't know it. I'm serious. Have you ever gotten a straight guy?
I'm telling you, Kevin is all man.
Do tell.
He's always ready. Wake him up in the middle of the night. Boom.
That's good to know. Yeah. Finish your story. Yeah.
I'm glad I know that about Kevin now. Can't wait to see.
No, he's all man.
He's all there.
He's all man.
Once he drinks his Viagra.
No, he doesn't need drugs. So what else? May I ask one more question? This is my boys' questions.
Are we almost done?
Yeah, we probably are done. Are we done?
All right. So
it's almost an hour and a half. Do we need any more questions?
Yeah, we do need a question. I want to hear from these guys.
Top complaint about women. Your top complaints. We're trying to get into the minds
of men.
Of men today. What is your top complaint?
That's the other book.
About women.
That's a lot. That's a broad question.
Yeah.
Broad.
Very broad.
But a boom.
You're trying not to say yes, anything that will piss your
it's
wife off.
A broad
off.
Question about these dames.
That we're supposed to know things that.
Yes.
I guess it's
I
both.
Know where
the,
you're going.
You know.
Yeah.
I guess it's both our problems. Because we don't think the same.
Right.
So one's thinking one way and one's thinking the other way, and nobody makes the effort to see how the other person is seeing things, and then they attack them for not seeing
when
it.
When you say
the way
they,
I
are you saying
it.
The woman
I'm
attacks
either
you?
Way.
Right.
The species.
But from my experience,
I don't see
having
why
not been
he
with many gay men as what, you have.
Right. I don't see why he doesn't sit down and pee instead of pissing all over the seat.
See, that is the most emasculating thing.
Yeah.
My wife said that to
yeah,
me once,
no,
too.
No.
I was like, you're out of your fucking mind.
It's because I don't see you, what you're seeing.
Yeah.
You you're obviously not
she,
seeing anything.
Your wife wanted
pissed,
you to sit in
pissed.
The seat.
She just said, why don't you sit and do it?
Just sit. Why do you have to piss? I mean, I'm tired of picking
but I don't
a piss
piss everywhere.
Off the floor. My son, too, whizzing all over.
He's the problem.
I would lose all credit.
He's good cover, too, now, in case I ever.
I would lose all respect if I saw Kevin or any man peeing sitting in a toilet.
Exactly.
That would be so, like, girly.
She's a woman. You're
would,
a man, she's
would
a woman.
Be,
that's how this works.
I wouldn't be able to, like, be excited about them after that.
I hope Kevin
First
doesn't
of all,
hear this.
When your man is in the bathroom, right?
Yes.
When your man is in the bathroom,
yes.
He's in there with the door closed. Why would you be in there anyway?
Sometimes I brush my teeth. Okay. Like, if I'm in
a
hurry,
no,
I'm like, knock, knock,
I don't
knock.
Need to hear him urinating or see him splatter everywhere. So when the door's closed and it's locked, he could sit down and pee.
But
that
you'd
would
know.
Be.
You would hear the velocity.
Instead of tinkle, 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 tinkle.
He would know, though. He would be. You would be taking away his...
whatever. Go.
He says go.
Go. So what's your complaint about us? You fuck.
obviously I haven't done well with the complaints because I'm single, but like you're expecting.
You said yapping. You were telling me once, women.
Yapping.
You didn't like
you're
yapping.
Outing him. Yeah. What did you say
no,
about
No, he didn't
him?
Say that.
Yapping. Yapping. What else did he say, Matt?
No, but the compiling of information.
The dossier.
Like, you drove in, you run into the convenience store, you grab a coffee real quick, and you where's my tea? I'm so sorry.
Wait, what did you say?
Where's my tea?
Let me get you the tea. No, it's okay.
No, because you forgot to get it.
You should have gotten her the tea in the first place.
How do you come
It never
back?
Really happened, but something like that. And then you go, and it's being filed.
Right.
Well, I do
and
remember,
then,
yes.
And there's... And I would interrupt her a lot when we were talking. No, you go ahead. No, I'm sorry, I interrupted you. No, you go ahead. Okay. That comes back, and then that's filed, and then, you know, and then you got there late, or you did whatever. You got out of the car, you didn't open the door, and then something happens, and it all comes.
Like a machine gun.
And they
you
bring it back.
Did this, and you know, and then I have a pattern. I have a pattern of behavior from the time that I didn't get the tea. I didn't get out
and it's in a loop.
And you're like,
we went through
you're
this,
like this
before.
You're like,
I can't believe
right?
it.
We went through, and
it's
you didn't
always
get it.
The same argument.
You didn't get it the last time. You did not get it the last time. And I told you about this loop of the pattern.
Yeah.
And you're like, I just want a sandwich.
You didn't know that about yourself. Now you know. Now you're clear.
As much as it sucks, it's very impressive too.
I can't remember anything, so I don't
right.
have any ammo.
Right. It's all gone. And I knew I had other stuff about her. But I can't, and I go, at that time you did the, and I don't.
You don't remember.
I don't file it away.
I remember.
Filing
system. Patty remembers
I
everything.
I remember every horrible thing that's happened to me. I remember. But see, my fiancé is such a great guy that he normally.
Stop saying that. Year.
My ex-husband, though, oh my God, my ex-husband, we fought. It would be like, really? Well, even to this day, like, we'll be talking, we'll be, you know, about the kids
he
or whatever.
Probably file things away.
And then he'll bring up, like...
Because you married a girl.
You married a gay man.
He bring up the time that I made him take the... I wanted him to take the kids because his house went on fire, and I had a gig to do. I had a gig to do, and I go...
Is that too much to ask?
It was my first gig in, like, 5 years. I go, I got to go do this gig. He goes, there's a fire in my apartment. You got to take the kids. And I go... You've got them this weekend. You've got the kids. You could stay in my house. I've got to get... He dropped the kids off and walked out and left me. So then I had to call and cancel. But anyway, this was the fight. We still have a fight about this. He goes, how dare you? But I remember this fight. Like, this yeah. fight will never fucking go away. It's like, he was wrong.
See, I would have beat the shit out of Cornhill. Because I'll tell you why. Because, first of all, he's not that big. He was a skinny little thing. I would have punched him right in the face. I would have said, pick up your kids and go fuck yourself.
What do I do when he walks and leaves? And to this day, instead of going, thank you, you took care of the kids, and, you didn't. Right. He's still mad at me because he thinks that I... But you have to understand, this was literally 20 years ago. It's still like right here in the... It's like
in his
mouth. When we start arguing, he always brings that up.
And he makes and a big deal about the burning apartment. Like, that's a big deal.
He could have gotten.
Really?
He
could have stayed at my
house. He could have went to his mother's. A
couple of flames.
Anything. He could have gone anywhere.
Want the kids?
Exactly.
Whatever.
Are we done, or should I ask one more question?
What's your other question?
It's not even that good of a question.
What is
it? This is gay. What makes?
That's your question.
What makes you cry, or do you have any emotions at all? Men don't even have emotions.
I'm getting worse as I get older.
You get more?
I'm losing my testosterone, I guess.
Do you cry more now?
Here and there. I won't let it out, but it wants to.
What's the thing that makes you want to cry?
I don't know. Like stupid shit. I'm turning like an old lady.
Like commercials?
Onions.
Or like
not commercials yet, but a movie will get me. I'm a sucker for movies.
What about your kids?
Beaches?
Do something
good. The kids, if you watch your kids sleep sometimes.
Oh, my God. It's so sweet.
Oh, and you cry?
I stop it.
Okay.
I'm saving it up.
Wait, you stopped there sleeping?
My husband does not cry. He's completely emotionless.
Your husband must have cried at some point.
When I, he did, you
when
know
you
what?
Beat the shit out of him.
He did cry once when I broke up with him, but I had already, wait a minute, I'll tell you what. We were dating, I break up with him.
That's so
and
mean.
When we got, he started to cry, and I realized
he was
later,
crying sitting on the toilet peeing?
No, I realized.
With his hairy back?
He had just paid off $24,000 of my credit card debt.
Dude. Oh!
So he wasn't actually love. Crying for me. Yeah. He was like, holy shit, I just lost $24,000.
Wow. Wow, that's great. Why'd you break up with him, though?
Because, I don't know, I was a fucking, I was hormonal. I was going through that clock is ticking. I needed a man. I needed a sperm. Yeah. I was like, look, either now or never. And he's like, I just met you 2 months ago. And
goodbye.
You're out.
Now.
We were having dinner. And we were at the salad part of the dinner. And I go to him, I want to have kids. And he goes, me, I do too one day.
And one day, fuck that.
Eventually.
2 months we're dating. I go, one day? Exactly. Fucking 39 years old. What do you mean one day?
Exactly.
We, now or never. You got to tell me you're either in or out right now. This is our last date. In or out. And he goes to me, oh, my God. He goes, can I finish the salad? I go, finish the salad. You can even finish the dinner. But I got to know tonight. Either in or out. And I guess he mulled it over during dinner. And he goes, I guess I'm in. Next thing you know, AIDS tests are being done. All these blood work is being done. If he's got any hereditary shit. And we started trying.
That's a very sweet story. Now, when did you cry?
At that story. Because that's when I'm dating now. It's like, so I'm 50. But if I want to date a girl closer to my age, if I want to have kids, it's the same thing. It's like, now, at dinner, you got to decide, like...
Are you dating women that want to have kids? Don't they
I
know?
Have.
Do you want to have kids?
I did. Now I'm getting older, but I don't know. I don't want to force it to happen. If I date a woman who's past her...
Yes, past her yes?
Past her childbearing years. After the salad. And the dinner.
No, but that's a smart move for you.
Then I'm not going
to
do it.
Hold on a second. But then if a guy doesn't really want to have kids, all he has to do is date somebody like me
exactly.
who's 50
He's
fucking
done.
Years old. And there's, you know.
Here's the problem. These guys, they don't want to date women who are their own age.
Right, because we're all heads.
I do.
Because we're all
Patty's
heads.
Right. Patty's
you're
right.
You liar.
I'm you married. I'll date yeah, anybody.
Now, you wouldn't.
How much younger is your wife than you?
You wouldn't date me. Young
7 guys.
7 months.
Know. Really?
So oh, okay, I wouldn't date you?
No, you wouldn't date me. You wouldn't date me. You
he told me.
I don't like
young
it
girls?
Feels creepy now. Like women under 25
oh,
now
so you,
seem creepy
well, no,
to
that
me,
is
for
creepy.
Me to be looking at.
No, that
I
is
feel
creepy.
Creepy.
But, you take a peek once in a while.
No, 35 I think is
I
good.
I can like appreciate, look at that pretty young girl, but there's
and that tight
I have nothing
butt
to talk to them about.
Well, you
no, they don't know what life
let's
is
say,
about.
Let's say your wife and you split up and you meet a 35-year-old.
Whose fault was it?
Obviously yours. Uh-huh. So you meet a 35-year-old. She's going to want to have those kids. Are you going to do it again? Are you
no.
going to be ready?
He probably
no,
what if you're
no.
in love with her? What if she's hot? What if she gives the best blowjob in the all
then
of
she'll never
night?
Get pregnant.
Then she's not
going to
get pregnant
to worry
that
about
way.
Hey!
Did you fail biology?
You didn't answer about crying. That was good. You didn't answer about crying. That was
what?
The question. He pivoted.
Now, I was raised by a man who did not cry.
Yes.
So crying was frowned upon.
And
I was too sensitive.
Did he ever catch you crying?
Did you cry in the garden?
Get back out there in the back lawn.
So you never cried.
Pick those weeds.
This is how sentimental my father. We were having Christmas dinner at their house in Florida. Christmas dinner. And then my mother, he's in the background. My mother goes, what are you doing? He goes, I'm taking down the Christmas tree. She goes, it's Christmas night. Get that out of there. No, he was sentimental about
oh
nothing.
God. Oh, my God. That's
nothing.
I wait till the next day.
Oh
the
my
next
God.
Day, you are a dude.
Mine's still up.
So is Patty's, apparently.
I always leave mine up.
She
I love
Valentine's Day, she keeps it up.
I did keep mine up when
really?
You Valentine's
wow.
Day. Yeah. Why not?
My mother's like, keep it up.
Well, if you don't cry now, I will make you cry later.
Thank you.
It's going to be an awful... See, if I start, it's never going to stop. That's how I feel.
I remember that.
So I'm not going to let it...
We hold it off. I get a lump in my throat once in a while.
Does Kevin cry?
He cries at...
at the thought of marrying you.
No, he cries at Yankeeographies.
What does that mean?
on the Yes Network,
he doesn't
right?
cry. Yeah. Yeah. He doesn't cry at them, but he wells up. He will not cry because he's a He-Man, but he does.
What is that?
That's, you know,
Yankees.
I told this on Kevin Sleep, but on Thurman, when Thurman Munson, you know, it's the Yankeeography on Thurman Munson. And at the very end, when Thurman Munson goes down in the plane crash, and I'm sitting next to him watching Yankeeography, I hear like a... Like the breath, and I turn around, and his eyes are all. He loved fucking Thurman Munson, and the Yankees back in the 70s. That was his. So that will.
That's understandable.
That's a safe thing for guys to get emotional.
Come on, really?
Brian's song. What about Brian's song?
Oh. But you had to run out of the room, Brian's. Like you had to go to the bathroom, like you're getting choked up. Like I can't let my sister see this. Boy in the plastic bubble, right?
Oh, that was some movie. That was
Boy
a cry.
The plastic bubble, John fucking Travolta. Wasn't that John Travolta?
Now you're gonna cry when you watch him.
Can I just ask Adam if he cries? Adam doesn't look like anyone who cries.
He's not a crier.
Never. He's too even keel.
You were crying before when I got in here. What are you fucking lying for?
Because he couldn't believe he had to do this shit again.
He was weeping.
He's crying.
All right.
Well, I think we're good, Patty.
I think we are too. Boys?
I would like to thank the boys
coming
to Queens.
They should tell us where they're going to be.
Next weekend, I am at McGuire's in Bohemia, New York, Long Island.
Love that place. A lot of good
Very
memories.
Very nice.
What's that, the 24th, 25th?
I think. I'm
yes.
Not sure.
20, whatever that Friday and Saturday is.
I'll be home in 5 minutes. I live down the block.
Okay, so where are you going to be?
I'd have to check my calendar.
Oh, well, that's good to plug.
Where am I going to be, for God's sakes? Where am I going to be? Carrie, where are you going to be?
Look, she's got a calendar.
Well, this weekend I'm going to Westbury Music Fair with Louis Black.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that nice?
You're working with Louis
no,
Black?
No, I'm going to see him.
Oh, okay. I thought, wow, that's a good
game. I'm going to go watch Matt at McGuire.
But I was asked to do Pablo Pababa at the...
Escobar?
Well, no, at the I was asked to do.
Better be good.
Pablo, what's his name? Pablisco, whatever his name is.
The Impressionist?
Yeah, what's his name?
Pablo Francisco.
Francisco. Yeah. To open for him at the what's that one in the Paramount?
Are you going to do your act?
I was supposed to go. They asked me if I wanted to open for him.
And
I said no because I want to go see Louis Black. I love fucking Louis. I've worked with Louis many times.
Really?
In the past before he became huge.
Really?
And famous. Yes.
I don't know him that well.
Yes, I love him. So I'm going to go and then I'm going to weasel my way backstage to say hello to him. And Saturday night I'm doing a private party in someone's home and I'm dragging Rich Walker with me because I hate house parties. So
you need someone to break the
ice. He's going to take the fucking bullet.
Yeah.
And I'm going to read the room while he's up there and they're not laughing. I'm going to be able to figure out which way to go with this
He'll
crowd.
Be very good.
Wait, what's going to happen when he's up there?
He's going to take the bullet. He's going to be crying. This will be a man crying after this fucking set.
All right. I am going to be in Bergenfield, New Jersey at the Bergenfield Firehouse something. I don't have the name of it right in front of me. But just look up.
No one's going.
Look up. They're going. We're almost sold out. The Bergenfield Fired, but it's a Jack Hoffman gig. You know Jack Hoffman. He goes to every gig.
I don't know him.
One of his gigs. Bergenfield Fire Department.
Great.
So look it up.
And we thank you all.
It's on my Facebook. Go to my Facebook and that'll show you where
Listen,
it is.
Listen, okay. You could catch us on iTunes now. It's Chick Chat, right?
Yeah.
On iTunes. And subscribe to it because the more you subscribe,
yes,
the more famous we'll become. Rate the show. Tell us if you like the show. And write a review. And that way more people will watch. And
also you can get it. We're on podcasts, right? You can go to.
Well, that is a podcast,
that is it?
Patty.
Oh, see, you can.
Shut grandma up at the
end. I'm really old.
You can download the app for iTunes, by the way. And then every time we come on, it'll click. It'll alert you. But can I just say one thing?
Can I do this on my phone?
All right, I'm old. Okay, I'm old. That's it.
I also, Kevin Brennan does. Begs for donations. If you want to donate to this show,
oh no, this is embarrassing.
Just send the money to the website. It's chickchatcomedy.com.
You have to set up a thing to get them to send money.
Or Jim Gallagher comedy.
You
got to
send up a thing.
Oh, I'm going to set it up then. And then, yeah, PayPal. I'm going to set up a PayPal, and then you guys could donate some money to Patty and myself, because we are struggling artists.
I don't know if I agree with this, but maybe.
I do.
Oh, all right. Okay.
All right. Thanks for watching.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.